Oh. Well, good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for coming. And it is so exciting for us to finally be able to do an in-person folk concert for you. For many of us, it's been about a year and a half since we've had a folk concert. And that's far too long. One of the things that I felt we might talk about before we start tonight is the first piece that we're doing is called The Awakening. It's a piece by Joseph Martin. Fantastic piece that we really enjoy singing. And text to that is really apropos for this year. I'm going to share a little bit of it with you in a second. But one of the things that, you know, of course, last March when everything kind of stopped, it was across the board, right? It was everything stopped and there wasn't a lot going on. And then as we eased back in and school started up in September, a lot of the classes were not normal necessarily, but they were very similar to what they had been. But classes like Symphony Orchestra, who played earlier, and Moon Ensemble, who played earlier, and certainly Chorale, well, we gained strength from singing together by being a group. And when we came back to school, we were so grateful to be able to sing because there were districts that weren't having any ensembles. There were districts in our county, great big districts, big music programs that haven't had a single ensemble rehearsal all year this year. And so we're very grateful to have what we have. But as we came back, we noticed, okay, masks, that's going to be tough. That's going to be a tough thing to sing with a mask on and have our sound come out enough, have the consonants come out enough, and so forth. We got used to that pretty quickly, I would say. It's a little bit of a hindrance, but it's not. Certainly not the worst thing in the world. The 12 feet apart was very difficult. And that took some getting used to. We are now at 6 feet apart, which is still a challenge when you're used to hearing somebody right next to you. But the 12 feet, that was definitely a big challenge. But I'll tell you, the thing that was hardest for us was that half of the group was there. You know, we have half of the group on Monday and Tuesday, and a different half of the group on Thursday and Friday. And these kids are so used to being together and creating something together. It was really difficult. It was emotionally difficult, musically difficult, and kind of left us feeling a little bit empty. So this last 6 weeks or whatever it's been have been really fantastic for us to be together and then for us to be able to share this with you tonight. We couldn't be more grateful about the experience. So, like I said, I want to share just a little bit of the text of The Awakening. I'm going to share a little bit of the first half of it. I dreamed a dream, a silent dream, of a land not far away, where no birds sang, no steeples rang, and teardrops fell like rain. No hallelujahs, not one hosanna. No song of love, no lullaby. And no choir sang to change the world. No pipers played, no dancers twirled. I dreamed a dream, a silent dream. And so I thought this is a great closure. It really is a great closing number because after all that sadness, well, things do turn around eventually, as we've seen, right? But it's such a great message for us to be able to share with you that we wanted to start with this. So please enjoy The Awakening by Joseph Martin. Thank you. year's senior class have been leaders since they got here in ninth grade, and they've been incredible this year. They have carried the torch and led us in such a powerful way. This is a year that has taken a lot of inner strength, a lot of self-confidence, and kind of convincing oneself to do things that are a little bit outside the comfort zone with their singing and with their leadership. And so before we do our final number, I would like our seniors, our many, many seniors, to please stand. Thank you. Have a great night.